Oh guys, me again. Tactics Forever. Other film was canny, but obviously the guys in Arcos had a watch of it. Had a bit of a laugh, but there was a few things I could have flushed out, and the guys in Arcos have put some nice meaty ships in as well. Because obviously most of the battles you see now were fighting drones. And obviously drones are crap because they've got no weaponry and they don't really fight back. And the battles are over in about three seconds. So, and also wanted us to flush out the building bit as well. I'll give you like a brief overview of the building, but there's a lot more to it. So I'll see if I can do it pretty quickly. So, built a ship. We've got everything there. I've got the guns in place. You've got all your weapons sorted. Everything's lined up. You've got them pointing in the right direction. And then what you can do, obviously, when you get your level cap up, you can start changing colours. So on these engines, change that to blue, right? Nice dark blue. We've got red ones there. Change that one to like a pink. Do that green. Okay. So that means the thrust that comes out of the engine will be the colour of the engine. So basically what you've got there is a rainbow effect. And that gives you the nice rainbow graphics and stuff like that. And I believe it's the same for your guns. So, you know, you make these different colours, then the discharge from the guns match the colouring. So you've got basically multicolours flying all over the screen. It's brilliant. Right, so you've made your ship. You've set your AI settings. So speed, high, range. Now I'm going to put my range to flexible. Now we'll go, we'll just leave it at that. Okay, now validate your ship. My ship, netty brush, little slogan. Right, obviously I haven't changed much, so it's just saved it straight away. Then what you do is you take it to the fight. So obviously you build your ship, you get it validated, but you're going up against the drone with no weapons. So you cannot really say, ah, that's a mint ship, that, look at that. You've got to get it in there and have a look. So let's have a look. So that's a slot 7 ship. So what you do is you get into your ladder, right? And then when you get into your ladder, you get a list. Okay, now these are all slot 7s. Okay. So, you want to know if your ship's any good? Fight one of the big boys. So we'll have a go on the first one. Not the test ship. We'll go for the one made by Andy. See what happens with this one. Now his ships are normally pretty meaty. So I should basically be getting teabagged the hell here. Engine colours, look at them. Got loads of colouring going on. Particle effects flying all over. Oh, Andy, I am so sorry. I'm not. This is interesting, this one, but see what he does. Open and attack that. Obviously getting gimped now, but had them swords, all three of them hit me square on there, that would have been absolutely off the shot. Let's see who else we've got. One foot scratcher, morning up. Oh, well, this should be fun. Going on there. Hold on. Got a nice circular fight going on. It's going to be a battle of attrition, this one. Oh! Now, see how your engine design can keep you, basically keep your head of the out position. So Buttscratcher's engine design was quite good there, keeping my head. Mine feel dismal. Oh, I'm gonna get crushed. So, engine design, you've got to watch out for that. Keep them fast, keep them maneuverable. Rock Lobster, how well, let's look. This is another one with good engine design. Very maneuverable. There we go. Hammer. I think this one's interesting. Let's have a go. Them bullets catch up with my shit, I am absolutely done for. What you'll notice is, see, the shields are working well on that. So, a little bit of weapon meter shields down would have been handy. And there's good line of, good rate of fire as well, prevents the enemies. Some of the enemies' weaponry getting through. There it is, sorry. Quite enough. Can you entertain that? Oh, I didn't want to be in there. No, didn't. Oh, go on, go on. Yes! Oh, I ran. Oh, can I? Oh, we got to go. Oh, that's fun. See what this one does. Oh. be a weight of numbers, that one, I think. Yeah, I'm spinning arms, do some damage, like. You see the physics working there, and obviously our cost is going to be working on that. Make the hinges better, and obviously have things hinged as well. Oh, I just got totally gimped on again. Any more on the... As you can see, the physics is kicking in there, everything's folding up and boom, hook dead. Now then, Arcos is working on the physics as well. I think he's going to be adding hinges and pistons and what have you. So you can imagine sort of the funky stuff you can get done there. And you guys are good with physics because there's a lot of physics games out there and I know you like playing on them. But if you're good with the physics and that, you'll probably be able to come up with some really wicked ships. Angel of Death, this sounds interesting. So keep an eye out for that. There'll be other videos released. Watch out for Projector Games and Morning After Kill. They're going to give you some more on this, but just something to keep an eye on there. Actually, this thing looks like a bit of a beast. This could be quite a battle we're going in. Go on. Angel of Death, that's right. Just kill me.
I'm probably going to get munchfuddled to hell here, like. Let's go. As you can see, the ship designs are pretty wicked. Oh, look at that. He's kicking the crap out of us. Now, notice what he did there. He's got his main core, right? Got his main core in the middle, just with engines, and you've got two arms made with, you know, engines and guns and stuff like that. And as soon as the battle kicks off, them two arms move in, and the core generally ends up behind them. So you've got to fight past the two arms, which are loaded with weapons, to get near the core. And phew, if you don't get it right, like, you're knackered. Let's have a go at this one. So you can imagine when this game kicks off, some of the ship designs are going to be absolutely spot on. Really funky. I mean, what's this guy? Ah, he's using the old drones. There we go. So you can have bits of your ship detach. If you build them detached, you've got spinning whirlwinds of death flying all over the place. Because the ship will always concentrate on the core for the battle. So everything going on around them, they generally take no notice of. So if you've got like turrets and stuff like that dotted around the screen, you can cause some bloody havoc. I'm going to have one more go on Bendy. So this is what you're doing, you're testing your ship, because when you put it out there, it's going to be fighting all sorts. So you want to make sure it's got, you know, decent range, decent... Now this is going to do exactly the same and get chinned. Oh, this time I won. So there's probably like a 50-50 chance I'm going to do pretty well against some, you know, pretty well put together ships. So I'm happy with that. But if I wasn't, I would go back into the edit screen, have a little tweak, you know, take an engine away, add an engine, add a different weapon and stuff like that. Validate it again and have another test. And obviously, you can always go into these and have a go. So if your mates are on the list, you can go in and kick the crap out of each other and call each other noobs and stuff. So that was a little view of that. So basically, when you're happy with your ship, now I've got a ship in all 10 slots, right? So what we'll do is we'll just watch a little bit of all those things. So we'll let you see some of the ships that's been built. Have a look at the graphics going on, the colours, and just have a laugh and watch the destruction. And I'll stop babbling. Well, he just got pulled out there, didn't he? Right, I said I was going to stop babbling, but I kind of keep your gob shut for more than 5 minutes. So, just to let you know as well, when you're leveling up and stuff like that, now it takes a while to get enough XP to level up to open the slots. Right, so you need some pretty meaty XP for that. But, Markest has got some shortcuts in there. So basically, if you buy the game, and you get two of your mates to buy it as well, and then you all three go online, you'll automatically open one of the slots. So it's like a shortcut. So if you can get, say, 5-6 of your mates to buy the game, and then you all go online together, then you'll open all, you know, a canny few ship slots, and that'll save you waiting until your XP's built right up. Obviously, you'll not open the weaponry to go with it, but you'll open a ship slot, so basically what you'll have is a bigger budget to work with on the ships, and then you can get your XP built up again for the weaponry and stuff. So it's quite handy, that. What else? I really should stop babbling. I'm going to keep my gob shut. Enjoy the battles. Oh, you like this one. The colours. Titanic face off there. Right guys, we'll call the day on that because I've been on you for too long. Okay, take care of yourselves. Bye now.